All right, hello, my name is William Lederer. I am the Executive Director here at the Chocolate Church Art Center. I am here with very talented and wonderful Elaine Hranich, whose name I am pronouncing correctly now for the first time ever, so I apologize, Elaine. Elaine has a wonderful show in our gallery at the moment called Maine Moments, and we thought we would just chat a little bit about it. The gallery is open at the moment, so we would love for you to come and check it out. So Elaine, welcome, and thank you for being here at the Chocolate Church.
Absolutely.
So I wanted to just sort of get a bit of background on you as an artist. What is your sort of background in the arts world? Are you formally taught? Are you self-taught? Let this car go by. So what is your background as far as an artist goes? Are you formally trained? Are you self-taught?
I am self-taught, but also get a lot of training folks who have been formally trained. So I take a really lot of workshops.
Great.
I don't know. They teach me and then it progresses. So.
And how have you been making art your whole life? Is it a more recent thing?
My whole life, but more recently I've gotten into using all the different mediums.
Oh, okay.
So you'll see in this show
that
we have oils, pastel, and water.
Do you have a favorite of those? No. It depends on the mood, I guess.
Yes. Great. Love them all.
And how did you connect with us? How did you end up having an exhibit here at the Chocolate Church Art Center?
Karina contacted me. No, I was supposed to be part of a show for the summer, which was Ladies of Summer, I believe.
Are you a lifelong Mainer, or are you someone who came here?
No, I'm from New Jersey.
Ah, okay.
But it feels like a lifetime.
Right. Yeah, sure.
But I've been here for like 17 years.
Nice. Great. And what makes Maine a sort of unique place to create and to be an artist, do you think?
The beauty.
Yeah.
And the mid-coast, you have the parks, and you can go into Freeport, and you have the farms and the towns all have charm. And then if you go down to each peninsula, each one has a different character. And you just go down in a different feel. And so as artists, we want to capture that feel, put it into our paintings and show.
Sure.
That's what we try to do.
I think you've done it very well. It's a beautiful show.
Thank you.
So in that creation of your artwork, what would you say has been sort of the most rewarding thing about that is in your journey as an artist? And then I guess the flip side of that would be what has been challenging about that?
Let's see. The most rewarding thing is all of the people that through doing shows and taking workshops. So aside from the art itself, it's really the people that make it.
Sure.
Being able to explore it all in mediums, that's really been fun. The challenge is, I have no more room in my house. And I think a lot of artists will understand this. We just run out of room.
Sure.
So that's my biggest challenge.
Sure. I can imagine that would be difficult. So with this show, and I guess with all of your artwork in general, what do you sort of hope that people will get out of it? What do you hope the reaction of the viewer of your artwork would be?
A piece of me. Meaning, a piece of me and a piece of me. I'm hoping that they'll take some artwork home with them, and it will touch them in a way that will remind them of something that, just was a good memory, and then to be able to put it on the wall and have it touch them that way.
sentiment. And I guess now would be a great time to mention that all of the work in the gallery, all of Elaine's wonderful work, is for sale, which helps support local artists like Elaine and also helps support us here at the Chocolate Church so we can continue to put on shows like this. So I don't want to get too, too much of a bummer or anything like that, but I did want to ask you, this has obviously been a pretty crazy year. Have you found that the events of this year, everything that's been going on, has had an effect upon your artwork as far as what you've been creating or maybe your mentality while you've been creating, that kind of thing?
I would say it's affected the art me in a way that I like to come here paintings, so I like to go places where obviously there's a lot of people in some of these places that I would take much of it, so it kind of crushes that.
Yeah.
But for me, it pushed me out of my comfort zone. Mm. I started doing videos on YouTube for,
right.
I actually work full time too, and for our IBM family, I did some videos for them because they're all stuck at home with their children and looking for things to do. So I thought, well, if there's any artists out there, budding artists, that they can use their videos to, show their kids and maybe get some interest in the arts. We want to keep that going. So.
That's great. Where can people find that if they're interested?
It's just put my name in on YouTube or elainefrommaine.com.
Elainefrommaine.com.
Make sure I get that link in there.
Great. I think we'll somehow magic that into the video here. I think we can figure that out.
Oh, good.
is there anything else you wanted to add about your artwork or Maine as a state or the Chocolate Church or anything like that?
Well, the Chocolate Church is absolutely gorgeous. If you're not seeing it, please come by. It really is. Benefit the Chocolate Church if you buy the art, so we would like people to not purchase or online this year, and you haven't done this before, but you can call and purchase the artwork online or on the phone, over the phone, and we'll ship it to you after the show. Also, if anybody wants a commission,
excellent. Thank you. Well, we'll put all of Elaine's contact information somewhere easily findable. Thank you so much for taking the time, and we're thrilled to have you here.
Thank you.